What's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to The Order. Arguably the most talked about aspect of Marvel's Midnight Suns is its combat system. I've seen a lot of debate about the card-based tactical approach, and I've also seen a lot of misunderstanding about how it works within the game. Thankfully, the people at Firaxis Games have provided us with a bounty of information via their developer live streams, and I wanted to share some insight into how the card combat system works and an overview of its basic mechanics as you get ready to play the game. Combat in Midnight Suns takes place in these tactical mission environments throughout the world. There is no grid format as confirmed during one of the recent live streams, so players can move freely across the map using the Move ability. Players will typically deploy a squad of three heroes into battle and can use whomever they want on their team unless a mission contains certain conditions that require a specific character. Every character in the game has their own unique set of abilities displayed in the form of cards, and each character's deck of cards consists of three different types of abilities: attack cards, skill cards, and heroic cards. Attack cards are self-explanatory. They attack, doing damage equal to the number shown here. Some attacks can also deal knockback damage, which can send enemies flying into the environment, other enemies, or even other heroes, allowing for extra damage. Skill cards are like the support cards in your deck, providing anything from healing to buffs, debuffs, or even drawing additional cards into your hand. Heroic cards are the most powerful abilities within your deck, requiring heroism in order to be played. Heroism is the Midnight Suns version of a special meter. Heroism is used to play heroic cards and to utilize environmental attacks, and you can build up heroism in a variety of ways. Attack cards and skill cards will add heroism points based on the number shown here, and some characters like Doctor Strange have passive abilities that will actively add heroism during turns. While attack cards add just one point of heroism, skill cards will add more heroism than attack cards. Your overall deck for each mission will comprise of 24 total cards, with each hero having an individual deck of 8 cards apiece. Each hero's deck must include at least one card from each of those three card types. Though there may be some instances where you may have more cards, such as specific mission cards and objective cards, tied to an individual mission type or scenario. Combat takes place in a turn-based format with no time limit. You can take as long as you like to think through all of your moves. You'll begin each mission with a random draw of up to 6 cards from your player deck. On each turn, you'll have the choice of the following actions: 3 card plays, 2 redraws, 1 move, and the use of 2 combat items. Keep in mind, these actions can sometimes be refunded on turns in certain instances through the use of specific cards or items. Redraws allow you to redraw one of the cards in your hand for a different card in your deck, and certain characters such as Iron Man have the ability to add additional effects to a chosen card by using the redraw mechanic on it. Using the move action allows you to reposition a character around the battlefield, either to avoid potential damage or to position them for a brutal attack or skill of their own. One thing to keep an eye on as you approach each turn is the icon above each enemy's head. This indicates which of your heroes that enemy intends to attack on the next turn. It's something you'll want to consider before you decide what to do, as you may want to move a character out of harm's way or use a tank character like Captain America to taunt enemies' attention away from someone else. Speaking of which, certain characters do fulfill traditional class-based archetypes seen in other RPGs. Characters like the aforementioned Cap, or the other Cap, Captain Marvel, have the ability to absorb damage through the use of the taunt and block mechanics, making them ideal tanks to help mitigate damage for your squad. Meanwhile, characters like Doctor Strange provide a wide range of support capabilities, such as healing and buffs, making them ideal party fillers capable of keeping everyone upright and at their best. And then you've got characters like Blade or Spider-Man, who are all about doing damage in a wide variety of ways. Or a character like Scarlet Witch, who's all about causing absolute chaos across the environment. Team composition is a huge part of advanced Midnight Suns combat, as finding characters whose cards synergize well with one another will pay huge dividends in higher level fights. Maybe you have a damage dealing character whose best skills use a lot of heroism. Well, an ideal pairing would be someone like Doctor Strange, whose passive ability allows him the chance to generate heroism for the entire team every turn. I really can't wait to see all the theory crafting from this game as players figure out who works best with who and what teams are ideal fits for one another. Now, I mentioned environmental attacks earlier. These are objects laid out across the battlefield that can be used to inflict damage on the enemy. While using an environmental attack does cost heroism, they do not, however, require a card use, offering you a way of inflicting damage without burning a valuable card play. If one of your heroes loses all of their health, they are effectively knocked out of combat and need to be revived in order to return to action. Most missions will allow for at least one revive on most difficulty levels, and you have the ability to use certain combat items that will allow for an additional revive or two. Not to mention certain characters like Wolverine have their own self-revive system baked into their abilities. Now bear in mind there is a mechanic in the game, combat injuries, that may affect your heroes when they are KO'd in combat. These injuries will alter that particular character's abilities if the character is used on a mission before their injuries recover. I know that's a lot to take in, this is something I want to explore further in another video. After completing a combat mission, players are awarded with a star rating based on their performance, and receive a bevy of rewards. Gamma coils, a loot box of sorts providing ability cards to add to your deck. Essences, which come in the attack, skill, and heroic variety, and are used to upgrade your various ability cards. Intel caches, which can be used to unlock new hero ops, optional side missions your heroes can be deployed on to earn new rewards, as well as credits and gloss, which can be used to purchase new cosmetic items. That covers most of the basics of combat in Marvel's Midnight Sun. As we get closer to the game's launch, I'll be posting more videos covering more specific topics and mechanics, but if there's something in particular you'd like to see me cover, let me know in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more Midnight Suns content in the coming weeks and months. Till next time, have a good one.